and gentlemen, welcome to the weekly show. We are returning to our original format here and skipping the introduction because we have so much to get to, including a huge announcement that will send shockwaves throughout the world. It is a bombshell. Take out your shells, stick bombs in them, and get ready for something explosive. First up, though, a joke or two. There's some statistics that reveal New York City is more dangerous than it has been in recent years, that crime is up over 20%. One of the areas that is experiencing 100% crime is Wall Street. Wall Street, they're committing crime around the clock. All right, so much for that one. But on that note, actually, the Obama administration is sticking their claws in another sector of the economy, now trying to take over Wall Street. First healthcare, now Wall Street. Crucial time in our history because as the Tea Party activists are becoming angrier and more fiercer in their rhetoric, and the government and the administration and the liberal supporters of them are also becoming more passionate, our country is at a crossroads, and so I find myself at that crossroads as well, and I ask myself, am I doing all I can be doing as an American citizen, as an informed entertainer? And the answer to that question is no. So, what does that mean, then? It means, and here's the bombshell announcement, in case you didn't realize my run-up to it, that I had some conversations with weekly show producers, and this is sad for me to say, but the sad truth is that the weekly show and myself, Matt Schneider, have come to terms on my release from this show. That is right. So it's very sad but true, but ultimately the weekly show has been canceled. yes. Well, at least we can laugh about it. Well, I don't know. The weekly show might continue in some format. I just will not be a part of it. So stay tuned for that. And what does that mean for me? That means in about a month, I will have some exciting news to reveal about my future projects. So stay tuned for that. But we have 4 episodes left of the weekly show on this second season commitment, and then I will not be here for a third season. If there is one, I don't really know. Don't really care either. Hate to be honest. But I will be back in a month on the final weekly show episode to reveal what is coming next. For me and for my fans, however many or little there are. So stay tuned for all of that. But what do we have this week on this week's show? That is still exciting. There's still exciting segments over these next 4 weeks, so I encourage you to tune in. Today, we have a black and white segment with Jewish words, Dixon learning some Jewish words, and then we have a Health Hurts segment, Outback Medicine, some cures for fatal diseases. So all of that excitement is coming up, so don't go anywhere.
Hey, Jews and Blacks out there. Today is the black and white segment. I'm black, he's white and Jewish. So now he's going to teach us some Jewish words while I can survive in the Jewish hood.
All right, calm down. Let's talk about kvetching. That's the first word. Kvetching. It'd help if I could pronounce it.
Kvetching?
Yes, what does that mean?
That means conversating.
It means what?
Conversation.
Maybe that's what you do in the hood normally, but this means complaining, so close.
Jews complain all the fucking time. 15% is too high to tip.
Let's move on to the next word, yenta. Jewish word, yenta.
Yenta.
What does that mean, Dixon?
That means that's the end.
The end of what? Of time? What do you mean? Like Armageddon? Yenta means Armageddon?
Yenta means Armageddon.
Why would that even mean that?
Yenta.
Phonetically pronouncing the word doesn't explain anything. What does that mean? Why would that translate into the end?
Yenta. A good Asian, good-looking girl, Asian girl, her name could be Yenta.
A yenta means a gossiper.
See?
Someone who gossips a lot.
Yenta.
Has nothing to do with Asians.
Okay.
Nice guess, though. Last, but certainly least, is yutz.
Yutz.
What does yutz mean?
Can I put that in an example?
You could put it in an example if you must.
So let's say Rabbi, aka Dixon, walking down the streets.
Okay.
Okay, and what was the word again?
Yutz.
And I go, yutz!
Why did you have to be a rabbi for that little example?
Because like, it fits in.
It fits in what?
The sentence.
Barely. Yatz actually is someone who's a socially awkward, clumsy person.
Yatz?
No, that would be Yenta was the word before. This was Yatz. Yes.
There we go, ladies and gentlemen.
There we go.
The Jewish words will be back.
So long. Shalom. Oh, you learned the word. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Outback Medicine with Australia's most famous medical man right here, Rashid.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Glad to be here.
Uh-oh. I'm feeling tense. It might be because there's so much pressure to make this segment good. Or it might be because I have high blood pressure.
That's right. That's the main show joke today and hot week. High blood pressure.
It's hard week.
Oh, it's an awful thing here. You know, you'd be surprised how many Americans have high blood pressure.
11.
No, way more than that. There's a lot of people out there who have high blood pressure and it's not being treated.
Oh, no.
So, we're going to keep it down here to the basics. You want to decrease that feeling that you have.
Yes. How do I become less tense?
You don't even feel high blood pressure sometimes. That's the worst part of it.
Oh, no.
It could be doing bad things to your body.
It's the silent killer.
The silent killer. You got it right. That's right. Alright, he watches his TV. He's been doing his homework. He does have a heart after all. So we're gonna do a little
work. Mister.
Oh, it's a figure of speech, you know what I mean.
Oh, you
it's
know,
a figure of speech.
Now I know I am tense sitting
all
next
right,
to
him. Alright, well, I'll just pop him a diuretic. That's the first line of treatment. First line of treatment.
You're gonna give me diarrhea? Is that what? How does having diarrhea solve high blood pressure?
No. There's a class of drugs called hydrochlorothiazide diuretics, which decrease the amount of water in your body
and
excess
increase
water.
The amount of diarrhea that exits your body.
Not exactly, legend. We're not talking about diarrhea here. If you have diarrhea on your mind, you might have to run to the loo. We're talking about water in your blood. So that's the first line of treatment.
Okay.
After that, we have ACE inhibitors.
ACE in the hole.
ACE inhibitors. Angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors. Very high-tech class of drugs, along with the drugs called beta blockers.
Ooh, sounds kinky.
Not exactly kinky here, but we'll get into that next week. The kinky drugs. Here, we got to protect your heart here. So
okay, let's protect the heart.
Pop one of these pills.
Pop it, baby.
You'll feel a lot better.
Well, you know what makes me feel better? When I get to eat whatever it is I want, and you know, you being the Outback person, I do love the bloomin' onion, so I love eating it. But sometimes I feel like it's not healthy, but I know it can't be that
that's
bad.
That's right. You'd be surprised. It's actually one of the unhealthiest meals in America. We don't have that down under. You should start baiting that Outback like I mentioned before. So, we're talking about hyperlipidemia, high amounts of fat in your blood.
Speak English. Hyper what? Who's it?
Hyperlipidemia. Lipids are another name for fat.
Oh.
Yeah.
Alright, so are you telling me then, oh here's my question, if I want to eat the bloomin' onion, what do I then eat so that I will then lower the offset the bad of the bloomin' onion?
Well that's right, now I'm not okaying eating bad food, but if you do eat bad food,
yeah, gotta eat it.
You'll want to take a statin. A statin is a great class of drugs that decreases your bad cholesterol. You know the most prescribed drug in the US?
Who doesn't? It's called Viagra!
No, that's not right, same company, but it's called Lipitor.
Oh.
That's right.
Fair enough.
So, you take your Lipitor, lay off the blooming onion, you'll see your LDL and total cholesterol going right down the slope.
Look at this! Heart healthy week with this guy. My heart already feels better.
Alright, glad I can help out your heart here.
My heart thanks you.
Alright.
My heart will go on.
Thank you for tuning in. Thank you, we'll leave you with here with this Celine Dion song. My heart will go on. Let's continue the good heart health throughout the rest of 2010. Thanks everyone.
Amen.
Again.
What a proper way to end this show. In case you're wondering about this hat and getup, it's because I don't care anymore. I'm done with the weekly show, so in 4 weeks, remember, I'll be back with huge news about my future project. And over the next few weeks, we will have excitement for you, so keep watching. So long, everyone.